What if you had a rare and unusual transaction that you needed to enter into QuickBooks Online? Well, in that case, you would have to make a journal entry. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now, you may well ask, what is a journal entry? Well, it's a way of changing the chart of accounts directly without making a transaction document. Now, usually transactions change your chart of accounts as soon as you record the document. But transactions also change at the same time another area of data in your QuickBooks Online. For example, if you make a customer invoice, then accounts receivable would change along with the chart of accounts. If you entered a vendor's bill, well, of course, the chart of accounts would change, but additional to that, the records of vendors and accounts payable would change at the same time for that very same bill. However, when you make a journal entry, only the chart of accounts is changing, and it changes the accounts directly without needing to make a transaction document. Now, you may well ask, why do we do journal entries? Well, sometimes we have transactions that are rare and have no preset document, and therefore, there's no other way to record that transaction. For example, if the owner of the company invests or withdraws a non-cash asset to or from the business, like taking equipment home or taking home equipment and putting it into the business. Well, there's no preset document for that. You would have to make a journal entry to record that kind of transaction. What if the owner buys an asset and assumes a loan for the asset? Well, now the company has more equipment, but you didn't pay cash. You now have a loan on your books. That would not affect the other areas of peripheral data, and there's no preset document for that. The only way to enter that type of transaction is to make a journal entry. And of course, the opposite of that, what if we owe money in a long-term liability? And instead of paying money, we give it one of our non-cash assets. Well, that's a very uncommon transaction. We can't just make an invoice or a check or a bill. In that case, the only way to record that properly would be to make a journal entry. Now, we also make journal entries to adjust the accounts. This means we make normal monthly accounting adjustments to adjust for the difference between the results in our bookkeeping and the way we have to report our final numbers. We could also fix mistakes in the chart of accounts without affecting other areas of data if we make adjustments as journal entries. Now, we will not discuss adjustments in this course. Adjustments should be made by your accounting professional after consulting you thoroughly and explaining what adjustments are needed. But if you're the bookkeeper, the top three transactions might come up, and of course, you need the ability to record them before waiting for your accounting professional. And that's why we will demonstrate them here in this video. So how do we make journal entries? Well, we open the journal entry window the same way we would open any window in QuickBooks Online. And of course, the idea is to change the account balances without changing any other area of data. So how do we do that? Well, you just make debits and credits. Now let's talk for a moment about this idea of debits and credits. You do not need to learn debits and credits for this video. You can enter the transactions the same way you see them demonstrated here if you have these transactions in your real situation. You can learn about debits and credits and all the other related concepts right here on this very website from a course called Accounting Journal Entries for Kids. So if you feel learning debits and credits would help you, it's very easy and it will take very little time to learn the idea. But again, you don't have to learn the idea of debits and credits. You can just watch how these transactions are demonstrated and enter them the same way. So how do you change the account balances when making a journal entry? Well, it's very simple. You simply put the money amount in the journal entry window on the side of the account you wish to change. For example, let's imagine that there's an account that is normally on the credit side of the trial balance. If you want to increase that balance, you would put the money amount on the same side, the credit side, in the journal entry window. But what if the opposite were true? What if there were an account in the trial balance that was normally on the credit side and you wanted to decrease it? Well, in that case, you would put the money amount in the debit column of the journal entry window because that's the opposite side and that would lower the balance by the amount that you put in. It will all become clear as soon as we show our example. We know that assuming a debt or a loan for a non-cash asset like equipment would be a transaction that we would have to record in a journal entry. Also, if we were paying back the loan or debt with equipment or some kind of non-cash asset, would also be a transaction that we would have to record with a journal entry. Now, in order to do this, let's add an account in our chart of accounts called Loan for Equipment and make sure the type is a long-term liability so that we can record this example transaction. So how will we do that? Well, we will open the chart of accounts and we will click New, and we know that the account type will be long-term liability. Now, the detail type is not relevant in this case. I guess you could call it other long-term liability, but the name will be equipment loan, or let's put loan for equipment. Click Save and Close, and now we have the loan for equipment in our chart of accounts. And this account will represent the money we owe to Staples or whomever we buy the equipment from when we owe this equipment. Let's imagine on May 16th, we assumed a $10,000 loan from Staples for more equipment. Well, we know that equipment is increasing. And as you can see, equipment is on the debit side in the trial balance. Therefore, we will have to put the $10,000 on the debit side when we record this in the journal entry window. And if equipment is being debited by $10,000, then logically, we must put the credit to the Staples equipment loan that we just created in the chart of accounts. And we know when we finish, equipment will be $10,000 more, making $14,515. And the Staples loan will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $10,000. Let's take a look at how to record this. We click the plus sign for the new transaction window. We go all the way to the right and we go down to journal entry. Now, the date of this journal entry is actually May 16th of 2017. Very important to put the right year. The rest is very simple. Click once under the word account to bring the pull down arrow, and as you can see, you can choose any account in the chart of accounts. In this case, it's the equipment that's increasing. And as we mentioned a moment ago, we have to put it on the debit side. Push tab. Why on the debit side? Because equipment has a debit balance and it's increasing. So, therefore, what should we put as the credit? Well, we know that we owe this loan for equipment, and QuickBooks knows if you have a $10,000 debit, you need to balance this entry with a $10,000 credit. And people who studied accounting know that a loan for equipment, a long-term liability, normally has a credit balance. After we click Save and Close, we can reopen the trial balance, and you can see equipment now has a balance of $10,000 more, $14,515, and the loan for equipment shows up for the first time on the trial balance as a $10,000 credit. To really bring home the point, let's do a second example. Let's imagine on May 17th, we gave back $1,000 of equipment to Staples. That means the equipment loan decreases and equipment is on the credit side. Therefore, we will debit the equipment loan. We must then credit the equipment itself, and equipment is on the debit side and it is also decreasing. So watch how we would record this transaction as well. We click the plus sign, we go over to journal entry, and again, this time the date is May 17th of 2017. This is our second journal entry. Click under the word account, and this time we go directly to the loan for equipment. Now the loan for equipment is on the credit side. So if it's decreasing, we do the opposite. We put the money amount on the debit side in the journal entry window. And of course, if we debit the loan for equipment and the asset account is also changing, that means we should credit equipment. Equipment is normally on the debit side, but if we make a credit, it will decrease. Can you predict the numbers in the trial balance when we finish? Well, equipment was 14,500 something, so it'll go down to 13,500 something. And the loan for equipment was 10,000, but we're decreasing it by 1,000, so it should be 9,000 when we look at the trial balance. And here we are. Equipment decreases by 1,000 and it went down to 13,515, and then the loan for equipment decreased by 1,000 because we made a debit and it's normally on the credit side, and now the loan for equipment balance is now $9,000.